I began by making a plexiglass mold. I used the bandsaw to cut the plexiglass. The fence helps me cut the pieces straight. Next, I assembled the mold. I used my hot glue gun for this job. I blew air on the hot glue to help it cool faster. I filled the mold with water to make sure I had no leaks. As you can see, I had minor losses. I sealed it with more hot glue. Next, I marked a piece of oak and cut it to size on the bandsaw. I hammered the piece and used a chisel to mess it up a little bit. And that's what I got. Then I hot glued the wood inside of the mold. I did that to prevent it from floating. I used a two-part resin. It is one part A and one part B mixture. I mixed the two parts together and poured the mixture into the mold. It started bubbling already. This rain is supposed to dig gas by itself, so after a while it was clear. But the next day I demolded the blank and it was full of bubbles. I read the resin's instructions and that might have happened due to moisture inside of the mold. Then I decided to make another blank. This time I used a scrap piece of walnut. I shaped it with a small V-carving chisel. Again, I hot glued the wood into the mold. And then I poured the resin. This time I used a lighter to pop a few bubbles. A couple of days later, I broke the mold open. And that's what I got. Still a few bubbles, but I decided to go with it. Using a sharp chisel, I cleaned off the edges. I used some 100 grit sandpaper on a plywood piece and flattened the blank a little. Next, I designed my pendant's shape. I then clamped the piece on the bench and used a hacksaw to cut the excess material. The hacksaw makes a really clean cut. I finished shaping on the sanding block. This was a nice moment for me to drill the hole for the string. Here I use masking tape to secure a 220 grit sandpaper on a piece of plexiglass. The plexiglass provides a really nice flat surface. Next, I moved at 320. At 500, I started wet sanding. The soft water helps the sandpaper remain clean. Moving on to 800. When I reached 1000, I moved on these micro mesh sanding papers. They go from 1500 to 12000. When I finished with the micro mesh, I had this. Then I tried this paste people used to polish car lights, but this didn't work out nice. So I used Yorkshire grit. I just rubbed it on with a cloth. There are guys like Heath Knuckles that can polish these things to mirror surfaces, but I don't have the proper buffing equipment, so I stopped here. Next, I added a leather string. And that was it. In these macro shots, you can still see many imperfections and bubbles. But overall, I really enjoyed this project. It was a great learning experience. See you soon with a new project video.